blue dogs, blue pit bulls. You call them blue pit bulls. And if you don't call them blue pit bulls, but you think you got an original pit bull or a real pit bull, which is a very rare thing to have, by the way. Most people are walking these dogs, which as dogs, they're amazing. They're great pets, some of them. It's like having a turtle or having a spider, an iguana, or having a chihuahua, or just having a dog. You know, animals should be loved. We agree on that. Let's get that out of the way. About the American Pit Bull Terrier, the history behind it, and how the American Pit Bull Terrier influenced the United States to be a strong country. The founders, the builders of the United States were influenced by those dogs. The United States today, when it's time to face adversity, they talk about a concept that was developed in the 1800s by the American Pit Bull Terrier owners. It's called the concept of underdog and top dog, which really means two dogs that were going at each other for a very long time. One was on top, he was winning. The one was at the bottom, was losing. It was the underdog and the top dog. Easy and simple. Whenever you hear someone saying, man, I'm ready to go, I'm ready to put a dog fight on these people and win this case and win this championship and become the greatest and so on and so forth, they're not talking about a German Shepherd. They're really talking about being gutsy and having balls and having courage like a real American Pit Bull Terrier. They're not talking about double X, triple X, fake giant pit bulls, all these BS. They're not talking about miniature pit bulls. And definitely they're not talking about blue pit bulls. Blue pit bulls or fake blue pit bulls were not on those era, and none of the men that were important on developing the real American Pit Bull Terrier were breeding those dogs. They were rejected. The only people that were registering them was the UKC, which they were desperate to get money because registries become desperate. They need to feed their families, and the only thing they do is register dogs. So if they have to register a donkey and label a pit bull, they will. You understand? If there's enough people that want the donkey, and they can change the name even better, and then we start registering these donkeys with something else. It is the business, and it's the nature of the business. I'm not saying they're bad people, but that's how it flows. Money and things like that, sometimes greed, okay? So let me move forward from this and tell you something else. Those dogs, they sold you the idea of a blue pit bull. And they sold you that idea when real supposed to be dogmen in the 80s, in the 90s, and 2000s stood quiet. And they're still quiet. They already retired. There's no real dogmas behind. What you have now is just the leftovers and some guys that are breeders and breed dogs and call themselves dogmen. But those are not real breeders. So no one before me came and educated people around the world and tell them people, I'm going to get that credit right now. I'm the fighter for the American Pit Bull Terrier, for the real American Pit Bull Terrier. And in that process, I'm educating people around the world to love and respect the real American Pit Bull Terrier. But I'm going to break a lot of hearts, and they're going to be hating me and gonna be disliking me because somebody sold them the idea that that blue dog is a pit bull, but he's as real as a fake Louis Vuitton bag. Everybody has one, but it's fake. Mine's is real, you can check it out. Whatever one you check on, mine's all real. I wanna tell you something else. Those people that call the dog real American Pit Bull Terrier today in their pages, they used to call them only American Pit Bull Terriers. I started calling them real, and they follow me. If you're gonna get a dog, even my imitators, those that bought some red dogs and started breeding, well, Chico's breeding red dogs, and he's getting a lot of money for his dogs, so I'm gonna start breeding red dogs too. And somebody, I mean, I know Chico don't like this bloodline and rejected it, but I mean, he's still Red Boy Jack, or he's still Tom Stambolio, so I'm gonna start breeding it. So even those guys, and they tell you things, bad things about me, but they imitate me. You can get a better dog from those guys than getting a blue dog. So all those guys that hate me, but they imitate me, I'm building up your business. I don't like you because you're not real. You're fake also like a Louis Vuitton bag. But your imitation is a lot better than the other imitation called the blue dog. My name is Chico Lopez. A lot of people might say these guys too hard. I got here by being hard, by being a true American. God bless you. My name is Chico Lopez. Take care. Bye-bye.